Let me make sure I change the title, though.
Alright, Josh, who am I getting out of this? Get a player pack, dude.
House gaming week. What week is it? 15?
Yeah, I got 2 games left.
15, and I am. Am I 9? Do I have 9? 8 wins. 8 and 5.
I have no clue.
Giants. You on here, dude?
I'm not on here right now.
Damn, dude.
I'm doing it right now, dude. I'm the brand new PC, dude.
Oh, you're on brand new PC?
I don't know. They went to Best Buy, but I don't know if she hooked any of the shots.
So she's getting Wi-Fi now. She's gonna get an actual Windows.
And he'll be stopped thing. Right around where he would have been.
Wait, that'd be a waste because I'm pretty sure that. Oh my god, I could have gave her. I could have gave her an ISO, dude. She doesn't have a CD drive.
Yeah.
And they always come with CDs.
I thought I heard you say that. Because you definitely said something. I wouldn't have to find them or something like that.
This is Le'Veon Bell. Oh, Le'Veon. Good job. Down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Le'Veon's going to rush for 1,500 yards.
18 yards.
What do you think?
After his performance last week, everybody saw it. Unbelievable. You can
I figured out why it didn't show your follow either.
I mean, why wouldn't you? Because
apparently YouTube makes it so people's subscriptions are private, so you can't see them unless the person themselves turn it off. They'll see another performance just like they saw the week before. Which is the dumbest thing I've ever heard. And it's 2nd and 11.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs.
I guess that's the thing.
Despite seeing the multiple touchdowns that came out for the
offense. I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed.
Le'Veon! Kiss him goodbye. Le'Veon! I wish Nick Chubb was. Dude, Nick Chubb would probably be a 99 this season. If he wasn't out.
The Browns have taken the early lead.
Earlier in the week when they had their scouting report meeting, this was the
explosiveness
that they talked about trying to contain. They were concerned about it all week, yet he still did it to them. Wonder how that's going to carry over the rest of the game.
The kickoff team on the field now, you say, will send this one away.
I can't remember.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
I don't think he has any crazy receivers, so he's probably just going to run the ball. I'll keep those at default. For now, see what he runs.
Jones and the Giants now with a 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Let's see.
They'll run for the first time. Devontae Freeman.
What? And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Yeah, he has speed.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough
guy,
right?
Like,
who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that field. I'm like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough
like
in here.
93, above 90.
Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28.
You don't think he's on the team in real life.
That too. It's true.
They'll run for the first time with Deion Lewis. They'll only get a couple up to about the
Now he has Deion Lewis.
Not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
Well, no, not at all. He's not using the lane staying in their proper places
and not allowing any lanes to open up. Or why doesn't he have Saquon in?
He also.
It looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game.
Mm-hmm.
How the fuck did that happen? Oh, he's running it. Oh shit. Well, hopefully I can get stopped. Yeah, I mean, I kind of figured that was gonna happen.
And down to the 15.
Yeah, I mean, I was not expecting him to run it there. I should have called him timeout.
55 yards on the ground. Terrific run from one of the fastest backs in the game today.
Dude, do you
it's because he's the fastest back in the game.
Remember when we were meeting with the D coordinator before the game and all he talked about was run fits, making sure our guys were in the right place so there were no creases?
They missed their fits, didn't they?
Yeah, there was no fit there. The only fit was at the end when he threw his headset down after that big run.
Now Lewis here on first down. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run. And it's
all right, time to put in work with the Packers up, Steve.
A pretty decent game.
At the Browns, 9-yard line. 6 yards on that last play. Here's
I got a big game against Texas Tech, dude.
I'm pretty sure this guy's just going to run it the whole game. I'm not opposed to.
Now they'll run with Lewis.
Stop it eventually. Only reason he's down here is because I ran a dime against him.
Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize the strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
All right.
Oh. Third and inches, and they've got some extra beef up front. Three tight ends. Jones keeping it on the snitch.
Oh, he didn't get it.
And after getting tackled,
and he got hurt.
Looking very slow to get up. We'll get
he did get it. He did get it.
Well, they've got three tight ends here on first and goal to add some extra mass.
Yeah, who's gonna be without Daniel Jones for two plays?
They'll run here with Freeman. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4.
It's a gain of a yard and it'll
set up. They're running gauge 8. He's literally running goal line, dude.
Near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
Oh, jeez.
Driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. Give him a loss of 6 yards, and it brings up third down.
Well,
they've had success on the ground on this drive, and that makes a defense more likely.
Okay, there's no way he doesn't pass it here.
Keep in mind, it makes him susceptible to play-action passes as well.
What a stand this
week. He's really not going to.
If they can get the stop here, third and goal.
He's really going to run it from the third and 10.
They'll try and run. Freeman. And he's not going to get anywhere close to the mark.
I mean, he might be tanking too, though.
Short of the yellow line. We'll give him a couple on the run as it brings up the
my
fourth
tank
down.
Is not going to work too well.
Graham Gano on for the field goal. A 25-yard attempt.
I mean, we'll see how it goes.
You should have let Cincinnati win, dude.
On the board, but still trailing.
How many wins do you have?
Five.
So yes, yeah. It's only three.
Dude, you're gonna be
in
no
the
pack.
Back after giving up the touchdown to start the year.
Yeah, I like the
I know, especially if you're the best players.
Positive for them. Feel that is true. About things
because if you don't my bad for saying you beat the Jets. That was like the word of the. That was the word of. That was the word of the day, dude. At work, we're just saying all these bitch ass people, bitch ass subs.
Officially, so a net gain of one there.
And dude, 26 yards line. On your.
The Browns drive about to get started. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, oh my gosh, game, dude. So dude, Le'Veon's already got 98 yards in the first quarter.
Things are going to work out in your favor.
Jesus Christ.
I got some recruiting to do. They offered one scholarship. Here's 100.
101 yards, 5 rushes, dude. You know about it. Yards on the pickup there,
and
it'll be second
down. And it is still early, just the first quarter, but you start prorating the numbers, and we might be in for some history.
I mean, that last run puts him over 100 yards already,
and we've still got 3 quarters to go.
I already talked to that guy. Let me look at these outside linebackers. Yes, guys, I'm gonna do so.
Oh my god, Le'Veon, you fucking animal! Oh my gosh, he's got 2 touchdowns already. With his second touchdown in this opening quarter. And the Browns are going to take it. He's on a mission tonight.
I know I should keep the focus and the spotlight on the hero that just scored, but tackling's been an issue for this defense all game long. I can't set that aside. We just saw it again here. Missed tackles leads to his long touchdown run.
Extra point splits the upright. Dude, is anybody plus 5 in gym or something? I'm finding way too many plus 5s, dude. The kickoff unit oh my is out god, there's a plus 6. This one away. Stands right.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
The Giants offense at the line, gotta ready hit the to begin their next drive. You know, Charles, guys. Season winding down, time to maybe look ahead to the offseason. What do you see these guys going after, either in the draft or free agency?
Well, with the season that they're having, just about every position is up for grabs right now. No one is really safe, but the focal point's always the quarterback position. And he may be auditioning to try and stay with his own current team. I think he's auditioning for the rest of the league to try and find a spot, because I think this team is looking for a new quarterback.
On second down now, it's Lewis, and tackled down after a gain
of
3.
Don't tell me they gave
with 1 yard to go on third down. He was taken
down by Grant. Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big time play?
Let's see if he goes. Wait. Now some movement before he got called. And we'll hear from our first wait, that counts as a play? That's kind of dumb.
Well, that's a tough, costly penalty, because now it makes it 3rd and 6 after the false start.
There we go.
Now Jones.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't pick that. Was right there. Giants, Jones to Ingram. Oh. Is he just gonna chew the clock the whole game?
Spectacular catch. Turns into probably.
That was the first. I think that was the first pass play for either team. We're almost out of the first.
It was Jacob Phillips who was able to bring him down.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough.
Don't worry, dude. You'll fucking play if you come here. You want to be close to home? No? Okay. That's cool.
I think I'm going to download that game and play it on PC. I liked its scouting way better.
I don't know. I'm more of a fan of 14, honestly.
How do you like the scouting?
I like the scouting better.
You what?
I don't know. I like it. But also, I understand.
Three for four thus far. This is 3rd and 8.
Because, I mean, you're actually talking to the guys here. But
I was about to say, no way he should be able to catch that. Sterling Shepard coming now.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want. Anytime they want to throw the football, there was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down
Washer,
the receivers and forced the incompletion.
Oh, this guy's not ready for it. What about him? Into this one, and
this is a rocket. Oh, he's scouted.
This guy doesn't care about
playing for a touchback at their
own 20-yard line. This guy doesn't care about playing right away. Oh shit, I have not made this guy any promises. I should have did a longer talk with him. Oh well. You like being home? Nope.
The Browns drive about to get started. And right now,
dude, I do the easiest fucking promises that you can make.
For a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it.
Right, like, now, I'll get you national exposure, dude.
2 yards, the loss, second and 12.
Are you acting?
Yeah, because, I mean, if you start doing well... Oh, what, do you think that it's a lie or something?
Yeah.
Alright, so let's spend some time with this QB. We're just gonna come out and make promises. Alright,
right, let's throw a pass play in here. My receivers need something too.
I will not redshirt you because you're like 10 times better than the quarterback I already have. What's your importance on playing time? You want to earn it.
Fuller, baby. Fuller.
Team touchdown now of the year.
And the this Browns add on to their lead. Dog shit. A 57.
So simple math here in the first half. They've had three drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Just well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we used to talk about an offense making adjustments, this right?
Wait, I don't know, dude. Maybe this guy's, like, new.
Some way, somehow to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage?
I'm already up.
Right now, they don't know where to go. I forgot when he took over the team, so...
He could be trying to get hurt.
I mean, even if there's not much to play for.
The Giants offense at the line, you know, ready to begin their next drive. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like
unless
the last
unless you
want
to do a bitch about losing after he's been losing. That team's been losing all year. Tony Jones, you can just out my way. Oh, a 65 overall running back?
No
wants to come.
Does that guy get on the field on this drive?
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But so, hey, listen.
I'm going to give this man a talk to him because he's not going to be a starter. I'll tell you that.
He's got an 81 that's a solid. The 30 to the 32. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3 yard game brings up.
I thought he got hurt. He did.
Brings up third and two.
Alright.
Throwing Jones.
Can't promise you I'm not gonna redshirt you. Tell you that for
sure. Damn, he has to punt again.
The contact popped the ball
I won't.
And it's fourth down.
Not if he goes
that's
for it.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let him get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Here why do all these power backs want to come here, dude?
Great blocking.
The 30,
on the return
take it.
Brings him for 25. And the Browns will take over first and 10. The Browns drive about to get started. They are clicking on all cylinders. They seem to be just scoring at will right now. And that's why they've
this stupid. There's so many stupid promises you can make. Like winning record against rivals first year on campus. Obviously, they're going to try to fucking win every game.
On second and 12, Mayfield.
I am going to have to look back and
see. I should have waited.
Couldn't hang on third down.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against
dude, I'm working
the pipeline
right here, dude.
So far,
but oh, this is a speed guy.
That worked quite well for the defense.
He may only have... may only be a 63. He's a speed guy.
Oh, good pick.
Popped in the air and intercepted.
He does not want to be close to him.
And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
Well, there definitely was some juice
this
on that pass.
Like,
and while tight ends don't always have the same reputation for hands as wide receivers do, in this case, that ball was expected to be caught.
Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter.
Guarantee a national title. That's crazy.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first.
That's just what Nick Saban's doing. He's just like, I got a national title for you guys if you're trying to come here.
They run. This is Lewis.
You know what? I don't want you, 58. He's from Steubenville, dude.
Not before reaching the 10-yard line. A big run there. 29 yards at a first. Well, he's broken off some big-time runs here in this first half.
Man, let's just face it. When you go into a game, you think you've got the plays that are going to work, but when you actually get out there and they're starting to happen, your confidence rises, and he's running with terrific ability right now.
And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. 5 yards is the tally on first down.
I think he's from a different state. Like, literally, this guy's from Georgia, and he's saying that he wants to move to a different state. And I'm in Ohio. Why can't I get, like, extra points for that one? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
This is Lewis.
That doesn't make any sense.
Oh, you get the first. Oh, he got the first.
And the flashy plays, as people like to call them, that attracts a lot of attention. But let's face it, when you're efficient, that can control a ball game. And I love the game plan they've got going right now.
Back-to-back 5-yard gains. Didn't force the ball downfield. Picked it up on the all ground.
Right. Yeah, offensive line.
And he is in.
Chuck Penny, dude.
Giants. Elijah Penny.
That's Elijah Penny.
And the Giants are able to draw a bit closer. And when the smaller guy can't power it across the goal line, Charles, sometimes you need to go with a fullback. They did. It worked.
What's that thing about force and mass? How's that?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Force equals mass times acceleration.
Oh, that's big time stuff. That's from the same guy the apple dropped on his head, right?
Don't want you.
Don't want you. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Browns take over first and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
See if I can get Fuller on another one.
About to get started. And following the interception, any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah,
dude, if I can get this, if I can get the number one center to commit to, that's so good, dude.
But you have to be careful. Njoku, you fucking pleb.
Because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here.
Well, that was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside,
I should be
the
talking
pocket,
to
I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage.
I don't have any more time.
But what often happens
to
now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
That's not what I wanted to do, but okay.
Dude, would you say that Texas Tech is bigger than
Akron?
Yes or no?
Brandon, all things considered,
wait, what?
They have to feel pretty good about getting that.
Did you say that Texas
game,
Tech is bigger than Akron? Like, ranked better?
Yeah, probably.
All right.
Mayfield from the gun on third down. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. They stop him for only 3 that time.
Dreamy won the club championship for the Jags.
On fourth down, here's Jamie Gillen on to punt. Back deep, Golden Tate.
What do you know about Jamie Gillen, dude?
He gets us away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the
sidelines.
This will be out of bounds, and they spot it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad.
15-yard line.
The Giants' offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They'll start things on first down with Deion Lewis. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts.
Texas Tech has a nice stadium, honestly.
We step aside.
This is where Patty Mahomes went to college, dude.
On second down.
Dude, I'm telling you, this dude's only running
here
the ball.
To the 26. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
First and 10 at the 26-yard line.
And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action.
Oh no. Oh, that should have been. That should have been first play pick six, but instead I got
a pick on Chris Band.
Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Now a dump off here complete, and they're able to get this one across the 35.
All right, I'm done choosing my play before he chooses because he keeps doing this dumb shit.
Has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey,
oh my god, my quarterback is so fucking dog.
Nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Throwing on first down, Jones. And a diving grab. I think he got that. Yes. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
The 41-yard line.
Here's a pass swung out left to his running back.
Bro, I'm getting picked off by like 300-pound fucking lineman.
The Browns will quickly use their third and
every linebacker in this game is built like a fucking truck.
And talk over what to do next.
Well, except my guys.
Certainly not what they were hoping for, as now they'll try to convert on third. Operating from the gun, Jones.
Get it, Wilson.
And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Over the dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass.
Oh, yeah. He was definitely right there.
He's getting a lot of XP from his punter, dude.
As he's on to punt for New York. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And they won't risk defending a return here. That one's out of bounds and it'll be spotted at the 14-yard line. The Browns drive.
Why is Higgins coming on?
And still plenty of time remaining here.
I have much faster
receivers. We'll see if they just want to protect that lead or try to add on to it.
Well, with as much time as is left on the clock, I would imagine it would be the latter. I think they're going to try and add on to it. So what they're going to tell the team is very simple.
Yeah, he was open too.
If you get out of bounds after making a play downfield, terrific.
Good job blocking kick return team. When I mean good job, that means they did not block.
Throwing again, Mayfield on second and 10. Throw left side complete. That's Bell.
Hurry, hurry.
Reaching the 25. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
And the Browns first down.
From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. Flushed out right.
I tried to do some crazy shit.
Isaac Yeddo hits it, and they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line.
First and 10 at the 48-yard line.
Dude, our counter is broken in NCAA 13.
First and 10.
Probably.
Looking left side, and he's got a man.
Wait, that's why is it making me run away from him? What the fuck?
After taking it a little further down inside the 40. It'll be a gain of 9, and it'll be second and about a yard.
It's a gain of 9. Brings up second and a yard.
Oh, they're blitzing. They're blitz. He's not fast.
And this one
is power back.
Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
Oh, Jones. Oh, Jones, please get that.
Very likely 4 down territory, even
Jones,
if they don't get
the dot there. This QB is so fucking dick.
And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the
37.
Now the Giants will use the second of their 3 timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action.
Do you have a safety on you?
The 37 on first and 10.
What?
You miss a kick? Did he get a safety?
Oh,
or
he missed a kick. Point.
Jones. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
Oh my god, dude. I'm gonna lose this lane off my fucking QB. He's done two picks.
Line of scrimmage again, the 30.
Which means I've done two picks, but what I'm saying is his accuracy is so bad.
To throw again, Jones.
Wait, he caught that? Wait, this game is trash. This game is so garbage.
Dot.
Yeah.
So fucking dot.
Should have been a dot to the other team. He almost passed that too. What?
I've never seen anybody run a jet sweep in fucking NCAA, dude.
Graham Gano set to kick off.
Maybe time
for on offense. 7 seconds to go in the half as the kick is away.
Hopefully not with Akron.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Yeah, I bet. All out blitz.
The Browns drive about to get started. And from this spot in the
nobody's
field,
covering the clock running back.
He's going to come in fucking three-man deep, the pussy.
That's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one
it.
More shot before the clock
nope,
runs out.
Likely time for one
final get burnt
snap
by
as they start out first and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And the giant rush gets home as down he goes. So we've come to halftime in a five-point game.
Jamal Sheard? Dude, he has Jamal Sheard, dude.
For Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
There you go, Ball
all right, Coach, thank guy, you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter
no, I chose to
three.
Kick it off first, but, you know, it doesn't work. Don't know why I even change it, honestly.
The Giants set to get the football, and they trail here as we get back underway in the second
get a
half.
Kick at them? Okay.
And that one will bounce out of the back.
Ooh,
of the end zone,
the first
so
quarter
start here at the
0-0.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, and you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Well, from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards.
I don't like this play.
Let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage.
Okay.
Three-yard
I don't
gains.
Know why the running back was throwing the ball there. But,
that's
okay.
What you're looking for when you're playing defense.
It was only a play action. I don't know why Jones couldn't be in there.
On second down.
All right, whether he would pick up a solid 5 here.
Yards here as he stopped near the 35 and the 34.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
3 for 3 on third downs. Sun blitz off the edge.
They'll try to run for it. Lewis. And he's going to run into a brick
and
wall
yes,
right in the middle of the field, and I don't think he got there. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively, and it likely forces a punt situation on fourth. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it. And they'll say it crosses at the 11-yard line.
Yeah. All right. I don't think he's throwing, dude. So I'm actually on my normal stuff.
O'Carr?
I thought he was throwing it, but I literally just was throwing. The ball back here, didn't surrender any points.
Now they'll look to add to that lead. And how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. This is Bell. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A good pick up there for the Browns, 15 yards. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Some tough running, but it only gets him to the 45. He was the tackle made by B.W. Webb.
We're going for it. We're at the 41. We're at the 41. We're going for it. We're not giving up that much. Defensively,
you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run. But the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
First down.
Play the Bengals?
We played the Bengals.
Oh, fuck. I swear it just saw the Steelers with the Bengals.
From the shotgun, it's a gift. The game might have been before 9. That was a night game with those shit like that. Where it's like, oh yeah. This is accurate. Yeah. On this drive, but not on this play. And finally, the first score comes with. Comes for a pick six by accuracy.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. What we call run fits, everyone was in the right place.
Now left side on the swing pass.
Merely nobody's been able to move the fucking ball.
Have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants 30. That'll move the sticks for the Browns. A gain of 12.
I do have three picks.
They ran that one well. And not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
Now a first down.
Dude, don't let this guy beat you.
And he'll take this inside the 30 to about the 29.
Le'Veon's about to have 200 yards, dude.
Logan, 2 yards on the carry there, it'll be second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense.
Makes it so much easier when their D linemen don't have fucking inside stuff. I could pass it to
sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
So that was David Johnson.
David Johnson. His fourth touchdown.
David Johnson.
And the Browns
his first touchdown on the team, dude.
Circle that drive because that might be one to remember. Well executed to give him a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes because it was jab, jab, jab. And
their
finally,
just the
haymaker
off on
to put that drive away.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
Kind of hold them, boys.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Giants take over first and 10.
Oh, my God.
25-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line ready to begin their next drive. These guys had to punt their last possession.
Stop running the huddle. I'm fucking crazy.
Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball,
why is every team in NCAA no huddle team?
They bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm. A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline and puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now.
Come on, Williamson. I need picks.
Break, contain, and get outside. My first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield because nowadays most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
Jump. On second down now, it's Freeman. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
He was taken.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Fourth and nine. Good hold by the defense. Totally give up.
There's Jones. Off the play fake. He's going to look deep down.
Finally, Denzel had to break the ice.
And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, you know,
he probably won't be able to run training.
So he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
Not change the play.
But I think after that run, the defense is getting back in the hole.
You got to keep your hands on that if you're trying to go pro, kid.
Maybe starting to question their confidence a bit.
Not,
they gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself,
I know he's not, but he's just got a fucking level.
He's just trying to get a free ride, dude.
Down at the 48-yard line. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
A free ride to the MAC championship.
Yeah.
Don't think I can make it, dude?
No, I don't.
Dude, I'm 1-0 right now, dude.
Now Mayfield. He's letting this one go for Fuller. Oh, wide open.
You know, it's the same old teams that are 1-0.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. Will Fuller.
Nobody has burners on this team. He's my quarterback in the room.
He's good. Extra point right down the middle.
Like, I don't have one guy that has
enough space. Should I keep adding on to it?
I say you just go full dick mode like I did and
just run it up. Right.
Yeah, just run it up, dude.
Set now to kick this one away and off it goes.
Yo, I just pointed a fucking pass, yeah, and it went all the way to fucking out of bounds, and it was at midfield, dude. Or it was at mid fucking the middle of the field, and I pointed it fucking right, and it went straight out of bounds. What do you know about that type of accuracy?
Line, ready to begin their next drive. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even for 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run.
That's not fair. They got 10 games on the team.
They've got to get their timing back.
This is going to be a touchdown. I can already see it. He's going to run it to this side.
And now a 10th carry for Freeman. He takes this from the 30 to the 34.
Freeman, the ball carrier.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one.
Okay.
And might need to just put that aside.
Go back.
Just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. On the handoff, Lewis, and he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35.
You're wasting my time, buddy. I need XP.
And it'll result in a fresh set of downs. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They run, Devontae Freeman.
Oh.
And able to break one.
Totally with that.
Quickly brought down, but a nice little gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and four.
6-yard pickup brings up second and four.
We're off to the fourth quarter here in week 15. Happy holidays to all. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Boys, just don't get burnt. Just don't get burnt, boys.
Probably not.
Second and four.
We're on a nickel.
From the gun,
He caught that, dude. He's getting some weird ass catches.
What a catch. 60 catches for him now on the year. This last one, a first down. Operating from the gun.
You're going to see me in your nightmares, son. Oh, Denzel again. That's number 9, I think. Dude, now Denzel's fighting for the interception title, dude.
Would
you have 2 picks with Mika?
I got 12 picks total or something like that.
12?
Yeah.
I don't remember that.
Like 12, dude. You can look it up after the game.
I'm telling Jank here. Cheesing the interception system, dude.
The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4.
The Ravens have waived RG3, dude. That's who we're getting next. They're not the Texans, whatever, Ravens.
You'd say, right?
You'd rather play for the Texans on the off-season squad, dude. It's all good. You know what I mean.
Meaning the fourth quarter is ours, and they certainly weren't kidding. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Add this game to the last one, and they move the ball over 50 yards in 2 plays.
First down, Browns.
I'm sorry, Weber, but we're about to run you into fucking dirt. Literally, everything this team has. Next to defense. But then again, Ryan,
I need Baker to at least get 200 yards. I think that's an achievement, isn't it? You know what?
200 yards?
Yeah. Oh, that's stupid as hell.
Looked like one of the Browns might have moved.
Well, down goes my running back.
Locks it in the audibles, too.
The full start backs him up 5, first and 15.
Boy, should be having this.
Mayfield on play action. He's letting this one go for Fuller. And Mayfield again with the interception.
Wait, that's not a touchback.
Isaac Yiadom in there to pick it. That is now 7.
That is not a touchback.
7 interceptions between last week and this week. 3 in this game, 4
I want a challenge on the fucking spot.
I saw the head coach write on his play sheet, make a little note. I hope he's writing self-scout. Bring in the guys that scout games for you with a different eye and watch him and see what's going on, and maybe they can pick up what the flaws are and hopefully they can correct them. Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Oh, Jones has just thrown his third interception. Picked off by Terrence Mitchell.
Boy,
so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing in some of these mistakes.
Ready!
His head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
And he's going to get this inside the 30.
Fucking Le'Veon has more yards rushing than Baker has throwing.
That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them.
Okay.
Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down.
Oh, this is a big 30 inches.
Out of the shotgun, it's Bell. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down.
250 on the dot on 19 rushes, dude.
Well, that's a carry.
How do you feel about that?
With. And throughout this game,
I wonder if I can get this.
With what he's given
he's a man.
Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the...
Ooh.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown.
Will Fuller, baby.
A
That's Will Fuller's third touchdown, too.
And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage. The kicker on. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead.
This time was a game day goal, dude.
Oh, I'm playing for Dev, dude. Maybe they're seeking
some revenge or who's the Dev? Like everyone. The other thing that I
always say to me is, my whole team.
Are they worried about playoff position? Right? Are they worried about do you need enough points?
I'll be like, you didn't hear about it? There's a new Dev thing where if you're doing really good in the season, you get chance to upgrade everyone's dev by one.
And he returns this to the 22.
Pettis on the return. The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Done bunch.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys were in for a tough one on the road. That has been how this ball game has played out. They trail big as we continue on now here in this fourth quarter. And he gets us to the other side of midfield.
Honestly, I should have let him score that. He says XB2.
Pick up a 34 yards. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. From the gun, Jones.
Oh, Wilson, motherfucker.
Been their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down.
Incomplete.
At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Team
this
is actually
the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep their...
Oh, there it is. Oh, he fumbled it. Oh, no. Oh, Wilson. Mac Wilson, you motherfucker.
Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage.
Just gave him a free first down.
Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive.
There's Miles. He needs a couple sacks, dude. Someone, the Vikings, got like 15 sacks in the game.
Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback.
I didn't even know
he had no chance to block him.
Jesus Christ.
After the sack. Jones.
There it is, Avery. About time.
Picked off by the linebacker, Avery Williamson. And you have to wonder, Charles, a game like this, five interceptions, what does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
But based on the fact that he's still out there and he threw a fifth interception, I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because otherwise, you need to get him out and fight another day because this could leave lasting damage if he keeps throwing interceptions.
They'll try and run some clock now with Bell. And he'll get about six up to the 20.
What if I could get 300 yards?
What'd you say? Players, isn't it?
Tough, oh my god.
Hard, gritty run, got behind
wish
his
I had the wide
side. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Soft through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. And he's going to have a Browns first down as the tackle.
268.
No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running
like,
game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just
why does this quarterback
and if you have the ball,
suck so
they can't score.
Bad.
And they'll get him down as he's inside
290.
10 more there and another first down.
Brendan, every great running backs coach that I've talked with has always talked about when you have great vision, you're not consciously thinking about your cuts and your moves. You're just doing
dang it.
And I think
that took him out.
Tonight. He's about to run them into submission.
You took the words right out of my mouth. I was just going to use that. For
David Johnson. Everyone's getting some love this game, dude.
Touchdown. This thing is ugly. Well, they just continue to roll. And Charles, for you and I, we want the close games. But
are you
them,
fucking shitting
so nice to enjoy this big
you said to run the score up, dude. So if I get yelled at, I'm just saying you told me to do it, dude.
I think they'd love to be able to capture this game, carry it with them from week to week, and be able to execute
well,
like this.
Well, I just blasted this,
the
this guy.
I'll
just keep fucking quarterback.
The
running back picked it up.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone.
Oh, that's sad.
Cuffs up the football.
Oh, that's sad. I am sorry, dude. Oh, God. I apologize.
Now, this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead.
The score, Browns 56, Giants 16.
I think I have the computer next week.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble return.
I think I could clinch this week, though.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. So quick on the spin.
Damn, his spins are OP, dude. He was getting like four people a spin.
The decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
At their own 18-yard line.
He's just gonna...
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory.
I'm trying to let them score one.
It does not appear that that's going to be
the case.
At
least they'll get some XP. Isn't Lewis old?
I don't think any of us were surprised that they decided to start this drive on the ground after the last two drives ended in interceptions.
Unfortunately, though, not a lot going on that first play.
Yeah, I think the anticipation was felt also by the defense.
They try again with Lewis.
Oh, I'm trying, dude.
This will be a short gain of three before he's brought down at the 22.
Honestly, I also want to get Le'Veon's 300 yards and see what it gives me, but
defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks, allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Come on, man. I want you to score, dude. Here, I'll even press my seat or my corners.
On third down, it's Lewis, and they will rally and stop him short of the first down. They get him to the ground.
He had 150 yards. Oh, yeah.
It'll be a gain of four, but it won't be enough. It leaves him with a fourth down now.
Not Le'Veon Bell day, but dude, if Le'Veon Bell could get 290 this game, then wait, what is he doing?
Well, the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay hopefully out and go for it on fourth and three.
So I'm trying to get 300 yards with fucking Le'Veon. He's going to be a faggot.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield.
Oh.
And now here is another
greedy
interception.
Greedy.
Williams picks it off.
Oh, I was getting so sticky there. Oh, I was getting so sticky. All right, 9-5.
Put up the amount of points that they did. What were they clicking on offense?
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you still think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all
I had work. 368 rushing yards that game, dude.
So for Cleveland, the final 2 weeks are going to tell the story for them as they move to 9-5 with a win. And they'll get another road date next week as their opponents will be the New York Jets. Meanwhile, for the Giants, they drop their 10th game now to fall to 4-10. And they'll be on the road next week for a matchup with the Baltimore Ravens. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon God. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
Well, that is a, that is an L for those
Baker,
zips.
214 yards, 9 for 16, 101 passer rating with 3 touchdowns and 3 picks. Daniel Jones, 32 passer rating. 8 for 21, 115 yards, and 6 picks. He didn't start throwing picks till the end of the game, too. Le'Veon, how many rushing attempts? 23 rushing attempts, 290 yards, 12 average, with 2 touchdowns. 5 broken tackles. Deion Lewis, 20 rushing attempts, 150 yards, 7.5 average, and no touchdowns.
David can Johnson. I see the transfer portal? I need to see the transfer portal right now.
What?
I need to see the transfer portal. I'm playing as the actual Pittsburgh Steelers. Can only throw 6-yard passes.
Oh, David Johnson, 4 rushes, 78 yards, 19.5 average, and 2 touchdowns.
Oh my god, this guy's bullets and overthrow, this guy's fucking
Will Fuller
is an overthrow.
5 receptions, 179 yards, 35-yard average, 3 touchdowns. But they only had one
god,
catch
this...
for 3 yards. Jesus.
This guy had
I'm
no
wasting Odell,
hands.
Dude.
Yeah, probably.
I could get something good from him too. Do your job on the road, 100 XP. Rush for 150 yards, 100 XP. And 3 passing touchdowns, 100 XP. We did get 2,000 team rushing yards, though. One win away from 10 career wins. 2,500 team rushing yards. 83% of the way there. 4,000 team passing yards. I'm 76% of the way there. Top of the mountain. I don't really know what that is. I mean, number one in the division. Definitely not getting that. Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Couldn't take an answer, we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around, it's like a hell in the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Couldn't sneak an answer, we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around, it's like the hell in the clock. Till all the years of the clock, I go back to bat when I'm doing numbers. All the mad that I'm driving the bus, so they threw me under. But they mad, they don't want to bust, so they boo each other. Think that they're the winning team, go losing, then they choose another. And that's okay, cause I'm competing with me, not you. I live with blessings like I can't stop sneezing, not you. I hate to break ball, I and there's no catch. I go and get the bag and I'm not bringing it back. I'm like a down QB. I put the pain in the past. If you ever had a problem, promise I didn't ask. I just may say fucking next week and throw in this 57 overall freshman. Ooh, Denzel upgrade? And he's got plus 2 morale. 93. He should be getting a superstar dev.
Man, that is the game.
Le'Veon got an upgrade. He's now a scheme fit. Carrying Jupiter. He's 28, so he shouldn't go down too much next year. The year after that, he'll go way down. Wyatt Teller upgrade. 84. And he's only 25, dude. We're gonna have him for so long. Avery Williamson, 83. Greedy, 81. 80 now. want to press or with morale boost? Dedrick Wills. I want to get him to a skill set. He's an 80 now. Never play by the rules. Guess I'm paying my dues. They gon' try to intrude. Pressing the multitude. Sanjay Stewart could end up pretty good if he gets him. Okay, let's see here. Oh, there's no way the Ravens are coming back now, dude.
Why you say that? Did they lose?
I won this game. So if they win theirs, they're 7-7. The only way, only thing they could do is tie, and I have both games on them. So I think that means I clinched division. Let me see. Should that should be what? How do I check that? Standing. I'm looking for standing.
Alright.
The show. I don't understand. How could I not clinch the vision? Nobody can catch up to me. Even if I lost both games, I'd still be first in division. I don't understand how that's not clinched. But whatever. Luckily, all the really, really good teams are on the NFC. Wow, somehow the Packers haven't clinched. Wait, what division are they in?
With the Vikings.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's kind of ass. Imagine being the... What rank are they? They are the fourth ranked team with 2 weeks left and they haven't clinched. I mean, obviously they're going to. Somehow the did the football team just go AFK or something? Completely. Patriots. I just don't understand. What's really crazy is there's only one AFC team in the top. Oh no. Two AFC teams in the top five. How are the Eagles?
With my ass.
Oh, I'm officially higher ranked than the Panthers, dude. Well, let's see here. If I look at the playoff picture, so I can still catch up to the Dolphins if they lose both their games. But I'd rather play the Jags, because I know I can beat the Jags. I lost to the Raiders. I'd either want to play the Jags or the Texans. And then, who else? What's the Texans record? I know I have game advantage on them. Oh. Yeah, I'm sitting my starters, dude. Cowboys lose, I'll be the 7th ranked team.
I don't know who YouTube bums are. You guys should get off my prospect board. Alright. I just gave this guy the wrong fucking promise. Thanks. I told him that I would not redshirt him, and he's only a 68.
See, but that's why I like that game. You can do so much more with scouting.
Well, he's gonna be mad at me when I redshirt him. If he comes.
Well, but in like 14, it's just like, I don't know. It's like, they took away a lot of stuff.
Now what? I'm just gonna hit you with it. Just gonna hit you with a scholarship offer, dude.
I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the air. Now we on top.
got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops, if you drop, I just hit my dance. I was top, they just watched, had to take my
all right, wins. I have an idea. Let's remove this guy. Look for a different quarterback. I'm supposed to scout these running backs, and I never did. I'm in the day, I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the butt, you in the way. Either you rollin' or rollin' the dust. You with us or what? Keep it running. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan.
Sorry, dude, if I fucking stepped on your fucking toes, dude. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on 10, 10, 10.
I got 2 hours of call left. Probably gonna spend it with this wide receiver group.
Miami play last 2 weeks. I'll determine whether I can make it second seed. Patriots, which he could lose. Raiders. Might lose. And the Bills. I mean, he's got some losable games. Has he already lost to the Bills? Oh, he crushed the Bills. This is a new guy. Oh, there's no way the Chiefs aren't tanking, dude.
Gardner Minshew has a fucking mullet, dude. Alright. Now it's time to play North Carolina and get our shit wrecked even more.
Do you actually play the games?
Yeah.
Whenever I tried to play college football 14 on the emulator, it was laggy as hell.
Dude, listen to my schedule next week, dude. Because we've been so dead, I literally work Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday, Friday. So I had the weekend and Wednesday off. Hopefully North Carolina isn't good. position, but they're probably better than us. We'll say that. Man, I should have put this freshman in, guys. Should I put this freshman in? 57 overall, dude. Or should I roll with this, like, 69? That's literally a bum. Like, I can't make any
more. Wait, what's the freshman's overall?
Like, 57.
You may as well put him in, dude.
This guy is just so bad.
You gotta get him developed.
He's a 66. He's a redshirt freshman, though. Did I redshirt him, or... I don't know if I redshirted him, or he's been redshirted. That's the only problem. What's this guy's throw accuracy? Well, I just want to see what his throw accuracy is. Throw power, the starter has the worst. Throw accuracy, the dude has the best. I don't know why he's so bad then. I meant to look for another quarterback before I started this game too. Dude, thank God I didn't have to play Washington.
Yeah, he absolutely dumpstered me. See what the score was.
What of your game, or?
Against Washington. 63-14. He's the only person that has crushed me.
Other than me, dude.
Beat me by 4.
Yeah, stop trying, dude. I didn't want you to quit the league on me.
Yeah. If the Dolphins win this week, I'm probably gonna set my starters for your game, dude. So you can take another win.
I don't need it, dude.
You need it.
I'm not gonna respond. I'm not gonna respond to you, dude.
Be back, dude.
I'm not gonna respond to you.
Dude, you know who's gonna be back, though.
Jerry Hughes.
No.
No, damn. Was that close?
Two guys are gonna be back, actually. One, I might end up just sitting because I have good replacement for him anyway. I'd like to get developed. But you know he's coming back, dude. The GOAT. My entire line has +1 morale, dude.
Alright, Cat. Stop it.
I don't know how Baker doesn't. I mean, I guess I don't throw that much, but...
Oopsie daisy, fuck around that
thing. Like still have some kind of morale boost. He's got -2, +3, +1, +4, +8, +12. He's +12 right now. I think you need +20 morale to get +1.
I don't know how it goes. Oh, Jesus. My guy just laid a fucking big hit on the running back and he injured himself. Was it a good guy? It's probably decent. We just have to stop the pass, boys. they are negative 5 on running. He caught that? A challenge? I don't think he caught that. They just set the stands, dude. They just set the stands. I'm gonna take a picture of it for you, dude. This is gonna be the greatest play you've ever seen, dude. No. Here you go, dude. Wait till you see this catch, dude.
Wait, what?
Wait till you see this catch, dude. This is a catch. Best catch I've ever seen, dude. Dude, are you playing league?
5, 10, no. 18. 20.
Please don't blitz. I can't fucking throw.
Dude, Le'Veon has 1,250 yards, dude. He's gotta be top running back.
Yeah, I'm choosing, dude, I understand. Sorry, dude, I understand, dude. You have to run a scheme.
A scheme.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, I learned it from the Broncos, dude. You see the Broncos are an admin now?